Hello everyone and welcome back to more The Letter Let's Play. We are back for more 100% chapter completion routes and shits like that. And yeah, so in terms of the last episode, we finished off on Hana's route. Oh my god, and that ended off like being polar opposites of what happened two episodes ago in her route, in terms of like we left off one time with her becoming super crazy and kind of possessed by Takako, and then the recent time we left off with Luke going psycho and ending up killing Hana. Oh my god, like what a turn of events. Anyways, so yes, we have that, but now because of that, we finished off 100%, and we left off on her story. Not too sure how I'm gonna proceed on to it, but anyways, we are currently in Zachary's route now, because that is the next character after we finished off on Hana. So as you can see here in the branching tree, yes, there we go. So we go from the very beginning. We have all this to unlock, and I'm pretty sure it must have something to do with certain choices from previous characters' route that would affect our story here in Zachary's point of view. So I'm pretty sure these are that, but I'm not gonna touch them just yet. I'm actually gonna do probably what you guys probably are already kind of guessing what I'm gonna do is this is one of the saves that I have for him in the very early kind of stages of his route. So here we are. We are currently here, and we have these two choices to go through. So I'm basically gonna go through all the choices that I haven't done currently in this branch, just to get all the possibilities there, and then I will proceed to go on to try to get myself down here in order to do some of the other different happenings that occur all along all this. Yes, so yeah, so that's my plan of action, because it's just easier that way. Anyways, we're gonna have to come back and do everything regardless, so might as well just start here what we have right now and then work our way to getting new shit. So anyways, yes, yeah, so where are we? What the hell is this? I think this is when Zach kind of woke up after his little nightmare, because you did have a glimpse of that, like his past memories. I don't know why Isabella is here though. I forgot why she's here, but she's just really, I think she picked up on like our kind of unease, but then so she kind of asked us the question about it. But then what did we say? What did I say? Did I say play it off or tell the truth? I think I said tell the truth, right? Yeah, tell the truth. So we're gonna actually play it off this time, and then yeah, from here on out, we're gonna just hopefully I can recall some of the events. But yeah, anyways, yeah, so let's just get on with it. So oh, what, this? Oh no, okay, there we go. She spotted our little medicine thing, jar thing. Yeah, that thing that he takes in order to like kind of ease his nightmares and shit like that. Yeah, so there's that. Oh yeah, oh what, this? Yes, the pills rattle against the container when I shake it casually in front of her. They're nothing to worry about. They're just vitamins, Bella. Yes, you know, the usual maintenance stuff. Can't be too careful these days, especially with how erratic the weather has been lately. Actually, I did come down with something last week. Forgot to tell you guys about it. Got me a little worried I wouldn't be able to make it to my own movie premiere. Yes. Good thing the virus, or whatever it is, left days before we're supposed to meet, huh? Although I think it's decided to come back for another round.
Zach, you aren't really sick,
No, I'm not. I'm not a very good liar either. Well, there goes that excuse. Yeah.
You're the nicest guy I know around, but you're an even worse liar than I am. I understand it's not a habit, but even I can tell when something's bothering you.
Yeah. you have no idea how many times I've been told that, haha. She shifts her attention to her hand, two fingers clasped firmly together at the hem of her shirt. I wonder if that's for sure gonna take down our relationship point with her. Yeah, for sure, because we didn't tell her the truth. Instead of the usual grin I'm expecting from her, she draws a frown, her lips pressing tightly together in a slight grimace. Seems like she wants to ask more beyond what I'm willing to tell, but simply can't phrase it. I can't tell if this sudden inquisitive, curious nature has been a part of her from the start, or she has merely spent too much time around Rebecca and Ash. Well, when she looks up, however, the question doesn't come. There's only a smile too reassuring to be genuine on her face.
Can you tell me one thing
okay,
at least
what?
About this and that thing when we ate lunch the other day? It isn't just about what happened to your movie now anymore, is it?
If she's talking about lunch, then I'm pretty sure she's talking about the time when she treated us after making the sale. I guess so. No, it ain't. That was never it in the first place. Just a simple statement of the fact, this much I can answer with all honesty. She nods then, her conflicted expression melting into something more pensive. This is her concession, yeah.
I understand. I'm sorry if that came off a bit pushy.
You're just worried. I appreciate it. I really do, Bella. There are some things that are harder to talk about, even with a longtime friend.
I get you. Or at least I think I do. I'm not going to pretend I could help and tell you it's gonna be okay. I know it's never that easy. But I'm here for you if you need someone to listen, Zach. You know that.
Yeah.
Right?
Alright. I could say the same thing about you. I'm here for you if you want to tell me about what happened yesterday. You were pretty shaken. Oh, can we skip? A laughter, almost bitter and likely a little harsh, slipped out from me. Completely unintentional on my part, perhaps even the medication talking, but the words have already been said, the damage done, leaving only enough room for regret. Still, she doesn't flinch. Only looks a bit torn with her mouth opening and closing in silent indecision. Okay, I'll hit the skip button. If it skips, it'll skip me. If it doesn't, then it'll just, yeah. Okay, I put faith in it. So I think we can skip on ahead. We got past the whole, like, he didn't really tell the truth kind of thing to her. Oh, nope. It's still going on. In the end, she settles for a deep breath, the release slow and steady, as if letting out the heaviness weighing on her. When she looks up at me, something, a small, unfamiliar, barely noticeable thing, slips by. As for what, it's impossible for me to tell.
I'll tell you. I promise,
okay.
I'll tell you. But not right now. Not when I need to make sure of something first. Please understand. Ever since I came here, other people, you guys, have always been helping me. You, Ash, Becca, even the job I have. I only got it because my aunt helped. I don't want to repay any of that kindness by dragging other people into more trouble than necessary.
Right.
I just want to try and fix this myself.
I don't think you could try to fix a curse all by yourself, girl. I should be happy. There should be pride in that despite the problems, she has found herself a stable ground to stand on. But somehow, this time, I find myself worrying instead. I'll make another attempt to get the story out of her if I can. But this is a dance I know all too well, and with her, I doubt forcing her to say something would yield any results. Okay, can I skip now? Okay, here we go. There's the next choice that we can make. I'm just going to check these journal entries just to make sure that there's nothing new. Isabella's unknown concern asks what it's for, not yet ready to reveal his painful past. Zachary played it off, saying they're just vitamins. Isabella didn't believe him, but didn't push the matter further. To lighten the mood, the two decide to cook breakfast afterwards. Okay. Yes, Isabella saw Zachary taking unknown medicine. Okay. There we go. So here we are, and I'm just gonna check my branch and tree just to be sure. Okay, you should stay. Okay. That's the next thing. Wait, what? I cooked up a feast. I know you're busy. What? Those aren't my choices. What is this? You should stay. Game? Hello? Those weren't my choices. I'm so confused. Where am I? Where the hell am I? Okay, I hope. I know you're busy. I cooked up a feast. Okay, so, okay, so judging by the way the path is laid out, then I'm pretty sure it's the bottom answer that I haven't done. So I know you're busy. So this, however, I know you're busy. It's okay, I know you're busy. I know. This is, oh, it's going down. My relationship points are going down. It's okay. All for the sake of science. After all, handling organized crimes cases ain't exactly what one can call an easy job. It's understandable the lack of time, his undeterred focus on his work. This has been a goal for him, I was told long ago. A childhood dream of sorts. Although I admit the disappointment is there. A small part of my person is looking forward to spending time with what few friends I have. This is something they wouldn't be able to give at the moment. We've each got our own lives to live. Yeah.
Sorry about this, Zach. I should have come earlier, but you know how things go back there when shit hits the fan. It becomes messy.
Okay. It happens sometimes. Yeah, life happens. I do have spare containers with me here, though. At least bring some of what we cooked with you. I wouldn't be able to eat all of it alone anyway. It'd just be a waste. Yeah, pack it for lunch. There's even enough here for Rebecca.
I don't have to go with him, though. I can stay.
Sure?
I'll just go home later. Catch a bus or something.
I answer her offer with a small smile of my own. Does she realize that unconsciously, in her own little way, she's taken it upon herself to look after the people surrounding her? Like her own family, in place of... No, never in place, but an extension of what she has miles away. Nah, it's cool. I need to be off somewhere soon, so it's a good thing. Ash arrived when he did. At least that way, you won't be alone. Yeah. In the company of another person, she'll be safer from her thoughts, from her own self.
If you insist. And thanks for letting me stay the night.
Okay. So, this is... now everything's coming back. Okay, now this is where she escaped from the office after her little ghost attack. And she came here to Zachary's place because it was the closest. There you go. Hey, no problem. But you should really call if you want to drop by next time. I could be out, yeah.
I don't plan to make a habit out of it, but I'll keep that in mind.
Okay. Let me just pack this for you two, alright? It'll just be a minute.
H right, 11 a.m.
yes, I'm gonna go see them. My hand pauses short of pulling one of the many empty food containers off the cupboard. Ash has taken off the post-it note I recently sticked to the refrigerator door. Although, from this angle, it appears more like the note itself has done him a world of wrong, and now he's glaring at it more than reading it. I got that one a few days ago. They wanted a magazine feature of their new home. Irman something, the same one Isabella sold.
Wow, they sure don't waste any time. I was just finalizing their papers for final approval last night.
You sure about this?
I've had worse. Also, it pays a lot for one-time work. Can't exactly complain when it's like that. Why? He doesn't comment on it further. He simply sticks the note back on its place among the mess of papers and receipts on the verge, and casually stuffs both his hands on his pockets. His eyebrows, however, are drawn together in a small frown. Ash may not say anything on it, but I'm quite sure there's something in his mind he simply can't voice out, likely due to present company. Alright, he stays wholly silent after. Packing for three people doesn't take long, and all too soon I'm leading the two of them out the doorway. A small paper bag swings in Isabella's hand when she makes her way out, giving me a casual wave as she takes the flight of steps down ahead of her companion. Ash, however, lags behind. Yes, he's gonna give us a warning. Go on, you can tell me.
I'm sure you know what you're getting into, but try not to get too involved with that couple.
Too late. Relax, I doubt they even remember me after this. I'm just a photographer passing by, nothing more. Though it'd be nice to get a regular client, easy on the pockets, of course.
Find some other one after this. Not them. Never them. Luxborn's
big enough. Okay, gosh. Okay, if it'll make you feel better? Yeah. He doesn't look completely convinced by my answer, but he nods nevertheless and claps a hand on my shoulder on his way out. A mild draft sweeps into the room as I close the door behind him, slightly disturbing the papers on the nearby fridge. A lone note flutters by my feet, the letters on the surface glaring at me with mute intensity. Aha, yes, the sticky note. I'm pretty sure we got new journals from that, yes. It's definitely different, yes. So Ashton arrived to fetch Isabella hours later, but she didn't want to leave after all the food they prepared. After a few reassurances, Zachary convinced her to come with Ashton. A brief talk about rights and Zach's upcoming gig occurred before the detective departs. So Ermengarde Mansion, H. Wright, 11 a.m. After Ashton's warning, they all hold a different meaning now. Yes. Okay, Thursday. I'm pretty sure I can skip on ahead. Yes. Alright. This is... Remember a chilling memory from yesterday's... Okay, now that's new. That's old entry. Anyways, where am I? Where the fudge? Oh, wow. Okay, yeah. I'm pretty sure these are just, like, story-influenced... story updates that I haven't gotten at this point. But anyways, yes. Where am I? Where am I? Tell Hana I did that, but... Ooh, maybe this might have something to do with either Hana is not there anymore, or she's got a little off her hinges. Okay, let's just go tell Ash. She'll show the photo to Ash. Someone has to know. Show it to Ash. Ash will give me flack for this. He will. I can already hear what he's going to say about this the moment I bring it up. Hell, before he even sees anything, I'll wager. The guy is a skeptic through and through, and it'll take more than my account for him to even consider this. But you never, where are we in terms of, like, in Ashton's point of view, like, when this is happening in Zach's? Maybe, like, he's gotten enough, a little bit of a taste of it to, you know, be a little bit convinced when he sees this? I don't even know. But when you've been there, seen something enough to raise the hairs at the back of your neck and leave you wanting to flee or hide, what he thinks is the least of my concerns. I am no hero. That's a title best reserved for someone else. Still, if this will help him change his mind, it's worth a try. Isabella's gone and done the same thing, didn't she? Outside, the sun has yet to rise. I've still got a few hours before dawn. Good enough time to mull over how I'll go about this with him. Plenty of space to check if I'll get the same result if I redo the process again. Okay. The film processor hums back to life at my touch. The light switches. The light switch gives out a soft click. The darkness embraces the small closet again. Can I... Somehow those urban legends don't sound so silly now. Okay, can I skip? But first, I want to save. I want to save. Just in case. I can save here. I'll only save over for choices, I believe. So yeah, let's just do that. Okay, skip. Okay, never mind. No skipping. Because we're the next day anyway, so sometimes I wish Ash would make himself easier to find. 24 messages, 13 phone calls, and one visit to his flat later, I still have no idea which rock in Luxborne he went off to hide under again. The guy has his own place, but he refuses to stay in it. Yes. Has his own phone, but doesn't answer any of his calls or give any indication he's gotten my messages. Most of the time, he'll just show up at my front door. Sometimes in the middle of the night, complaining how uncomfortable it is to sleep at the back of his Shirley, his car. As if the old couch in my flat is any better. Nothing new from him, though, but a bit frustrating, really. There's the police precinct, of course. Then again, he's not there most of the time either, and if that's also true for today, he's likely out on another stakeout. There's nothing much to do for me but to wait if that's the case. Let's just hope I'm lucky enough today. He's so elusive. My goodness. And we actually visit the precinct. Oh my god, this is the first time we've been to the precinct that Ash works in. While Luxborne is a relatively peaceful city, boasting a low crime rate, its precinct stays abuzz with activity. As soon as I open the glass front doors, murmurs coming from the people waiting in the lobby welcome me. Officers can occasionally be seen shuffling in and out of the rooms, greeting civilians with a casual smile and a polite nod. Some, though, look a little worse for wear, like their receptionist, who looked at me with much disdain the moment I arrived. Oh no. Thankfully, I won't have to deal with him today. Before I can even step in, Ashton's voice, though low, comes from the hallway adjacent to the lobby.
Not even for just one minute?
No. The case was dismissed, remember?
Ooh, this. Who this?
You were the one handling that case.
Is it his superior officer?
If you want access to those records, you've got to ask Chief. I was taken off it before shit went to hell. Why do you even bother? Even Professor Clark seems to have given up on that.
Yes, that's the case that Ash has been working on. Yeah.
Well, I... Never mind, you won't understand.
Yes, very sentimental. Has a lot of sentimentality.
Right. I know you owe Professor Clark a lot, but the right guy isn't just someone you mess with. They've got the money. Who knows what else gets swept under the rug with them involved.
That takes a special kind of ignorant not to know.
And a smart person to know which boundaries he can't cross. You're a bright guy, you'll figure it out. In any case, I've got to get going. Another missing person case on my hand. Benjamin on the front desk looks like he's about to maul someone after the fourth one yesterday.
Damn, yes, and it involves the mansion, of course.
Murders, people missing, what a time to be alive. Man, I miss the old Luxburn.
Uh-huh. You and me both. I'll see you. Gonna go grab some lunch.
So, Ash! He notices me first as soon as he enters the lobby and pauses. Confusion briefly crosses his face until I fish out the phone from my pocket and wave it up. Frowning, he pulls his own mobile out, wordlessly fiddling with it for a few seconds before sighing heavily. There ain't any annoyance in him when he glances up, though, only mild exasperation and what might be a hint of amusement.
Stop taking pointers from Isabella. This is gonna get old
then
soon.
Then start answering your phone. Jesus. At least use your phone properly.
It's an alarm clock, a good note-taking device, a halfway decent camera, and maybe a music player too. If I'm being
nice. You have a pretty shitty phone then, God.
What else do I need for?
To communicate? I don't know, keeping in contact maybe? When he merely shrugs, I know I've struck a chord. He's far from holding a piece of technology in contempt, of course. Ash has always been nothing but practical from the start, and technology is useful. Right. Only when he gets too focused on one thing, like a case he's handling, he tends to forget there are other things around him. Yes. A little reminder and a nudge in the right direction can get him a long way.
I've got an email on that social media site the girls roped us into joining.
Oh no! Ah! Okay, stop that. Haunted keyboard. That doesn't make any sense. Also, you got an account before any of us had one.
For policing purposes?
Oh, are you like, what's it called? Creeping? Using it to creep?
Anyway, why are you here? I thought you have something scheduled today. Or was that yesterday?
Oh my god, I can't even keep track of the days, but same though. That was yesterday. Look, about that, there's something I want you to see. Oh, he stops me with a tap on my shoulder, walks past me straight to the door, and gestures his head towards their very irked receptionist when I raise an eyebrow in question.
Over lunch. I haven't eaten anything since last night, and Benjamin there doesn't really like loiterers
right
around here.
Okay, sorry, yes. Wordlessly, I follow after him, but not after sending the poor guy behind the table an apologetic smile. Yeah, my bad. As expected, he takes a seat in the farthest corner of the cafe, a good way from the window, but easily allow a view of who comes and go. Secluded enough not to be disturbed by the lunch hour rush or be overheard by a curious bystander. You really are a cop, huh? If I didn't know this is lunch he invited me to, I would automatically assume I got dragged into another stakeout. After years of knowing him, though, this has simply become one of the many habits he has I've gotten used to. Food arrives minutes later. Ooh, oh my god. He had his own face on his latte, are you kidding me? A slice of their vegetarian quiche for me. Meanwhile, Ashton has opted for a cup of coffee plus a gracious serving of, is that pudding? Mousse? Cheesecake? What is this? You're having cake for lunch? He shrugs and then proceeds to dig in without even a hint of remorse. Wow. Frankly, it's like seeing a child get his Christmas present early.
Don't tell Becca. I'll get an earful.
Yeah.
It's just
for
today.
Are you sure? Yeah, you're kind of low on blood sugar or some shit like that? You should listen to her, though. The kind of work you do, you'll need to eat something other than sweets. I don't want to see you drop dead in front of my apartment again.
I told you, just this
okay.
once. Have you been hanging out with Becca lately? You're beginning to sound like her.
Nah, just for some recipes. But she has the right to worry, you know. It's like she's taking care of two kids. One binges on sweets while the other on cup noodles. Oh my god, yeah, it's true. At least Bella knows how to cook.
Hey, I can at least boil something.
Boil what?
Wait, that's easy, right? I mean, you just put water in it.
No, don't even think about it. You destroyed your own kitchen once by sicing a pressure cooker on it. Sticking a pressure cooker on it. Yeah, God. I think my sister is a whole lot better than you, and this is coming from someone who has no other choice but to eat her cooking for some time. To be fair, he genuinely appears offended at the last remark. Hate will be too strong of a word to describe how Sis and him usually interact whenever they're in the same room. Whatever appropriate word it is, I can say with most certainty that the feeling is mutual for both. Ash thinks she nags too much, while Sis thinks he's a trouble magnet I should stay away from. They're both technically right on their assessments.
How's your sister, by the way? Still bullying white guys?
What should I say? Oh, lol. This is new, right? I'm pretty sure this is new. Yeah, because we're down here because we've totally avoided... Jesus Christ. Yeah, oh my god. Yeah, we've totally avoided all this up here. Whoops, none of that. I said I was gonna keep with my path, but... Oh, well. That's new shit still. It's whatever. Wow, damn. Zach has a lot of shit going on for him. What in the hell? G6. Okay, enough of that. We need to just carry on. Okay, save this because it's new choice. Save. Yes. She's married to one now. You're the one who started it. What should I say? She's married to one now. Ish? Yeah, she's married to one now. You do know she's married to one now?
I hope she doesn't end up poisoning him
with
her cooking.
Oh my god. Ah, that's... Of course, that would give him plus points with me. Okay. Pot calling the kettle black?
She can't be better
than
me.
Oh, come on. Actually, she is now. They're planning to start a restaurant sometime in the future.
I was bedridden for days after eating some of the stuff she whipped up. And now you're letting her cook for other people?
Oh, come on. People can improve on their cooking. Don't exaggerate. It was just for one day, and you're the one who refused to leave your apartment. You should come by, though. Sis gave birth a few days ago. Girl. Aw. I've only seen the pictures, but I might visit sometime after everything's settled down. Too many backlogs to go through for now.
No way in hell. She'll just find something to criticize again.
Come on.
Last time, it was Shirley.
Hey, now. He makes a show of being utterly mortified, though I'm quite sure he doesn't mean any of that. He might not say it straight out, but I'm pretty sure he's enjoying the small visits whenever he can. Something about it reminds him of his own family, sort of like making up for the one he never got back after his parents separated. Sore spot, that one topic, one thing he never even brings up in any conversation, if he can help it, and I've never seen the need to be nosy. Right, very sensitive topic. There are some wounds you're just not meant to open, and for the both of us, the sentiment goes the same way. Yes. As if you ain't already on her shit list, you're just afraid of her.
In your dreams. But I'll think about it. Can't just drop this thing at the moment.
His change in tone is subtle, but his aggravation over the matter hangs completely palpable in the air. Still no closer.
The opposite,
really.
Actually. There's been some slip-ups here and there. Careless mistakes, and let's just say I'm waiting for him to make another one.
Well, so we're talking about the case now.
What about you? How are things in
Europe? All piled up on top of the other, but I can manage. Still recovering from the expenses for the movie, so the surge in new project helps. Yeah. And well, there's this one thing. This. All this. The expression on his face grows more puzzled with each photo I spread on the table. There's about 8 of them, all of it reprints of the same thing, Ms. Wright's distorted head on the photos. He takes a minute to go through each, eyeing the prints warily. The furrow on his brow doesn't ease even as he gathers all of it into one pile and sets them in one neat stack in front of me with a heavy sigh.
Hannah,
yes.
Right?
Oh, yeah? How did you...
The locket. She never takes it off. Evan's family heirloom.
Which she replaced after that one route possibility. Yes, I can't talk today. I won't even think about asking why or how he knows that. Well, he's got a lot of background checks done, okay? If he's investigating them, he'll likely have already dug up every unimaginable dirt on them, including family history.
Are you done with your work with them?
For now. Yesterday, yeah. It's just a small feature for a magazine. Interviews, photos, standard stuff, nothing big. But see, here's the thing. I don't really know how else to put this out there without sounding crazy, but there really is something odd with that place. Remember the letter... Oh, nope. He drags in a breath, reaches up his nose and pinches it. Like the action alone will help him grant all the patience in the world... In the word to continue this conversation, yes.
Please tell me this isn't about that again.
Oh, come on, Ash. No, Ash, you gotta listen to this. Gotta listen this time. God damn it, listen to me.
I am listening, and I can't believe that just came
Shut
out
up.
Of your mouth. These are some blurred out photos, and that letter is just a stupid prank. I expected this from Isabella,
Which
not you.
Which means that something's up, because if it's me involved, then you know there's some shit happening.
You're the photographer here. I don't see any need to get worked
but
up over this.
But I didn't do any of this. I know what you mean, but will you hear me out first? Ash leans back on his seat and doesn't say anything further. He gestures for me to continue with a wave of his hand, impatience clearly on his face. Any other person telling him this and he'll walk out without batting an eye. I suppose the only reason he's giving me the benefit of the doubt is because we know each other. Ash, I don't easily buy into these things as much as you do, right? Yesterday, though, behind Hannah, He blinks at that, his eyebrows lifting momentarily before settling into a deep frown.
Hana, since when were you on a first-name basis with the right
missus? Oh, come on! That's what you're gonna take away from this? Why does that even matter?
I thought you said this was just a gig.
Oh, shut up! What? His voice stays level, but the accusation in it is as clear as day. It hit a nerve in me, somehow, more than that tone usually does. Alright, I do get where he's coming from, but... Okay, let's see if I can find another save slot I can do. Yes, probably here. Go. Do it. Alright, that's not the point here, it's really just a gig. That's not the point here. Of all the things I said, my connection to the rice is the first thing he points out. Oh, that might have... Yeah. Oops! Well, that really is not the point, though. As much as I want to keep my own annoyance at bay, I can't stop it from seeping into my voice. That's completely beside the point here, Ash.
I warned you, Zach.
I get it, alright? But you can't just expect me to turn it down after I made a commitment to a client. I've got to put food on my table.
I didn't say you shouldn't, but you should not be messing
great.
With them.
Oh great, now I messed up my chances of trying to get the story to him. Not like he seems like he would want to listen to me anyways. Oh, whatever. Whatever, Ash. Ugh. God damn it, Ash. I wasn't messing with them.
And this isn't?
My God. Oh, he waves the photos in front of me before dropping the pile on the table with a loud smack. I don't need to look to know we've already attracted some attention from the lunchtime crowd. Besides, turning away from him feels almost the same as admitting he's right. There are things more important than his damn case right now. I wish you'd see that. It was a job, and that ain't how these photos were intended to come out. You'd think I'd go out of my way just to edit something like this? There's something weird going on here.
And you think Luke Wright will see it that
oh my
way?
God.
You think the Wright missus will find it
no,
amusing?
No, that's why I didn't show her. I did not do this for my amusement, Ash. People's lives might be at stake here.
If you understood that in the first place, we wouldn't be having this stupid talk.
Oh my God!
Luke fucking Wright is a dangerous man,
Zach. I get
it!
Jesus Christ, like, listen!
Keep hanging around them and you'll find yourself burnt to a crisp in your apartment or floating down a river three days later. This case is-
Will you stop talking about the damn case for once and just listen to me? Why do you think Isabella's-
Don't you- dare bring her into this! We're talking about you and
but
this stupid-
all connected! That's what I'm saying! Of course you don't want to talk about it. Because you're fucking afraid there's some damn truth to what she's saying now that there's two of us. Oh, every expression drains from his face as soon as the words are out of my mouth. But I do have a point though, that's what I'm saying! I was like, okay, Isabella's one thing, but now I'm involved. It's like, hey, if I'm involved then that means something's happening, right? Like, that's when you know, come on. Oh shit. They've hit their mark, yes. Each utterance scathes sharp with nothing but anger and the truth. Yet they are also things I won't typically say out loud in good company and rather ease people into it before letting it fall. Almost immediately a wave of regret washes over me. Ash, dude, that ain't what I meant to.
You said enough,
damn.
Zach.
I fucked up here. Jeez, oh no. Keyboard, stop. Damn. Okay, without another word, he stands, his chair scraping loudly against the floor, all while my brain races to find something to fix this. Ours ain't a fragile friendship by any means. I like to think we've gone past the stage when we find everything the other says insulting. But there are times when letters and phrases alone can cut deeper than any blade. Mine might even leave a scar. Yeah. He doesn't let me, however. Oof. Instead, he sets a card in front of me. University of Luxembourg, Andrew Clark, PhD. Oh, it's this guy. The professor. The name is familiar, but amidst a cloud of remorse swirling inside my head, I can't bring myself to recall where I've seen it.
You shouldn't be running blind. Call this guy. He'll be less inclined to shout at you. Might even talk some sense into you.
I don't see his face when he leaves, and it is only when the store bell chimes again do I breathe. Okay. Well, here we are. Jesus Christ, that was kind of... Oh, man. So disturbed, Zachary decides to show the photographs to Ashton. During lunch at the coffee house, they briefly discuss Zach's sister before the topic veered on the photos. Refusing to believe his friend, Ashton advised him to talk to Andrew instead. I feel like this might have happened regardless. Anyways, instead, like, I'm pretty sure Ash would have been more gracious about it. He'd be like, hey, if you need someone to talk to, how about this guy kind of thing? Instead of just kind of throwing the card in our face and be like, go talk to him. Of all the places, it never crossed my mind I'll end up wandering into the public library today, considering I rarely ever visited. Yes. Somehow, there has always been this kind of disconnect between me and books in general. Sure, some of them held my attention in my youth during the brief times of the day I was left to my own with nothing to do. I went through the whole of Grant's collection, as a matter of fact. Read all of them twice or thrice even, but they never did hold it for long. Most of it never even sticked. Especially after I learned it's simply easier to do things myself if I want to learn stuff. Okay? This ain't in the plan in the first place, God. But after that argument, I really don't have any other choice. Nothing but quiet greets me inside, though. Not the typical mum one would associate with a library, but one akin to a hush prior to an impending trouble. Okay. Or perhaps I'm just overthinking again. I really like to think I'm just thinking too much about this, that this is just a lack of sleep talking. Regardless, apart from a group of students murmuring in a corner somewhere, the place is free of its usual visitors. All while my footsteps echo in a manner unsettling enough to raise the hairs at the back of my neck. Much to my relief, it does not take me long to find him, being the only occupant in this side of the room. Hello, Professor Andrew Clark. Yes, I've never personally met the man, but Ash has spoken highly of him several times. In fact, he is Ash's go-to guy when something's troubling him with a case. My steps are unsure as I approach. At any rate, he greets me with a warm smile like a grandson he hasn't seen in a long time.
Ashton's friend, I take it.
Zachary. Oh, so you've been expecting me?
You'll have to forgive this old man if I don't get your name right.
Oh no, you got it. It's Zach. Zachary Steele, Professor Clark. He gestures at the empty seat across the table while he returns to his books. The next couple of minutes pass in a relative silence as he continues to read and take notes from the pile he's accumulated on the table. Maybe I should have taken a book first before heading here? I don't know. But before I can even get far into that idea, the professor clicks the book shut and sets it atop the stack next to him.
Ashton told me you were hoping to get answers from me.
Yes, so I was expected. At my confused look, he lets out a small chuckle.
He sent a message ahead. A friend needs to have some sense knocked into him. In verbatim. That boy never changes.
No shit. Yeah. I wasn't really expecting he'd do that.
Although I'm not quite sure what I could share, I'll do my best to help.
Of course, there are a lot of things I want to ask. How do we get out of this mess is the first among tens, hundreds of concerns in my head. But in the presence of someone I barely know, the thoughts won't easily form. He is nothing but patient, however, and with enough time to mull over, a question finally forms. Do you believe in the paranormal, Professor?
It's supernatural, actually.
Okay.
Don't worry. It's a common mistake to make. But they really are two different things.
Really? Tell me.
The other one deals with what we can't explain at the moment, while the other are things we may not have an explanation to. Here.
Oh. He places a couple of papers in front of me, the very same one he was writing on earlier. A study of Luxborn supernatural culture in a nutshell.
A friend of mine wrote that a few years ago. He took interest in the city after reading about the stories.
Okay.
I have to agree with him here. Even stories dealing with things you don't see with the naked eye can be rife with culture. And this city thrives on it.
Is it Ryan Bruguera and Shane? On BuzzFeed Unsolved?
Just ask the locals.
Like a ghost, for example.
Among other things. The interpretation has changed over the years, though. Various religions, for example, have their own version. It might not always be a spirit now.
Okay.
It could be a memory, or an imprint, an echo, so to speak. Some are born from curses, even. Out of great anger, hatred, or pain.
Yeah, it's a curse.
There was this one story.
Is it about the lady? Oh, we're gonna get it? Another book is pulled out from the stack and placed open atop the papers while he speaks with such passion that it makes me wonder if some part of him believes these to be true. It is interesting, though, even if I'm personally not a fan of such stories. Right. And soon, hours pass without my notice.
In the end, it asks for something to be sacrificed in order to destroy whatever anchors the Wraith.
Okay.
A sad tale, that one. But the simplest grudge can bring the ugliest, even in the kindest person, with some people none the wiser. Mm-hmm. Oh, I'm sorry.
No,
I just
went
on.
No, it's fascinating. And I'm pretty sure he just kind of finished up on that story, yeah? Yeah, about Takako, yeah? Because the grudge thing, yeah? Nah, it's good. Are you familiar with the Ermengarde Mansion, though? Who's not?
Of course. That goes without saying. Who hasn't heard of the local legend? Hmm. In fact, you aren't the first one to ask me about that recently.
Is it with Isabella? Because I think going into this story from my saves, I actually had that happen. Because we said to agree to see the professor rather than the priest. So yeah.
Although, word of the mouth is, someone has already bought it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the right couple. Yes. It was a close friend who handled that sale.
So I heard.
Yes.
Well, don't think the house being bought by anyone would stop us from talking about it.
I know, right?
What is it about the mansion,
then? Some curse. Like, some backstory that we're not getting in the public. I just want to ask what you think of it, sir.
We're going to need more than an afternoon for that, young man.
Okay.
You see, it's the kind that has changed over the years, passed down from one person to the next. Sometimes, it's the Lord William who haunts the place. There are versions where it's the lady of the house.
Perhaps it's all the above, you know.
But my favorite, a personal favorite, would have to be the ones that followed after the disappearance of the kind daughter.
Is it Elizabeth? Right? That's her name, right? Oh, I forgot. Well, what about these then? There is a moment of hesitation on my part before I pull out Ms. Wright's photos and lay them all out in front of him. Yes, unlike Ash, though, the professor inspects each print with great interest. That gives me some hope, at least. Yeah.
When were these taken?
Need some advice, Prof. Okay. Yeah, they were taken just yesterday. Just the other day. Do you think those are the same?
Perhaps. Perhaps not. There were certainly instances when the film would pick up what the human eyes weren't able to see. But then, it could also have been human error.
No, I'm a professional. What are you talking about? I didn't edit it in any way. You have my word on that, Professor. They all just came out like that.
Then, if it is what you're thinking, I'd strongly advise against doing something reckless and further tangling with them. Accounts about them may be riveting to you, but most of it often ends in an unpleasant manner.
Like someone dying. What about those people in the house? If there's something in there, shouldn't they know? I'm sure they're already familiar with the legends, but...
Some people might deserve it, however.
Yes, of course! Duh! Of course you'd be like, ah, fuck the rights. Like, I don't care about them. Let them die. Deserve? What, sir? Deserve? Oh, yeah. All of a sudden, the tenderness in the professor's eyes disappears, his face becoming unreadable. Yes, oh no, he did that anime glasses thing, where it's just fogged over and you can't see his eyes. As though catching himself, he hastily clears his throat, gathers his books, and rises from his seat. Professor?
I'm sorry. I just remembered something I neglected to do. You'll have to excuse
me,
Zachary.
Ponder on your vengeance. Alright, do you need any help with that?
Don't let my looks fool you, son. I can still carry a few hundreds. I've been doing this for years.
He looks pretty beefy, so.
I'll see you some other time if you have any other questions.
Alright, of course. It was nice knowing you, Professor. He doesn't hear it, however. Yeah. In a few short strides, he's out of the library, leaving me and every piece of this whole mess amidst the oppressive stillness. Despite the answers gleaned, more questions surface. Right. We didn't even get the story! Like, he kind of alluded to it, but it's just like, meh. Okay, Zachary met with Professor Andrew Clark at the library. The professor shared a few of his favorite stories about the city, including a friend's research about its urban legends. When Zach showed Hannah's distorted photos, the professor only warned him not to be reckless, and that some people deserve what's coming for them. Right. If there is even a single way out of this, I hope we find it soon. Well, yeah. Okay, so can I... Wow, that's a lot of new story shit that we got. I think we're here. There's a story update for here, but let's just fast forward just a little bit and then see if it'll take us somewhere else. Oh, there we go. Okay, so just a little bit of a skip. So an invitation and a request to come... and a request to cover an event, the Wright's housewarming party, tomorrow evening. If only it were that easy, but it'll give me a chance to talk to her. Yes, about that thing in their house. Yes, with a sigh, I let my hand fall to the side of my bed along with the invitation. Okay, there we go. So, it's because we haven't... I assume we got this through mail, then, because we didn't personally meet up with her. Okay, skip on ahead. Oh, pff, and another change. Belatedly, it occurs to me that the last meal I ate had been the one with Ashton. And an empty gnawing ache makes itself known, but I can't bring myself to stand up. Yeah, ugh. Today was a complete waste of time and frankly a disappointment. Yes, I don't like this. The lack of certainty, the disquiet, the lack of stable ground to stand on, the part where I do not know what will come tomorrow. Ever since the damn letter, everything has been thrown out of the loop. Okay, there you go. Now we can skip on ahead. Okay, this is where we stopped. This is where at the park and we meet... what's her face? Who is this again? Who is this? I wasn't paying attention. I forgot, I actually forgot her name. But yeah, we meet her after I think we had a little bit of a nightmare incident, maybe? I forgot. I skipped over it. It didn't really show ghostly showing up in our bed, but yeah. I think we were shaken up by that. So I even got into a fight with my best friend because of her. Yes. I think so. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Hard to keep up with things that are like that, you know? Especially when you can't do anything. It's kind of scary. It makes you wish things will just stay as peaceful as they used to be.
Maybe she just wants to be friends
Kylie,
with you?
Yes, that's her name. Kylie. But no, Kylie. She doesn't want to be friends with me. She just wants to kill me. Anyways, so there's that change in sentence just because we had that fight with Ashton. Okay, there we go. We're going to skip on ahead. No? I highly doubt that. She already hurt one of my friends. Yes.
What if she's just sad? Or maybe she just wants
help.
She has
a funny way of showing it. Okay, can I skip, please? Alright, so aren't spirits supposed to be humans before too? Yes, they were. Had people they cared about lived a life of their own, smiled and laughed like the rest of us does. Yes. Do they really lose all of it after death? Well, if they're so, you know, consumed by hatred and anger, then I'm pretty sure. You better get to school, though, or you'll miss sports day. Right. Okay, so gonna skip on ahead, then. Okay, what do you want from us? This is where Kylie gets possessed. The response never comes, however. Yes, because when I blinked... Gone. What do you want from us? That was a change in dialogue, really? Huh, whatever. Anyway, skip on ahead. Okay, there we go. So, Isabella and Ash stopped by our place after we got back. So despite things we've yet to strain out before it blows up in our faces, having something normal play out in front of me, no matter how childish their antics can get, I can't bring myself to muster even a tidbit of it. Right, so they're just hanging and chilling out at our place. Behind me, the television starts blaring the music for the end credits of a movie. Okay, yes. I think this is where they're going to talk about more about what's been happening and going on, and Rose's death, I believe. Yes? Yes? Okay, anyway, skip on ahead. If this has something to do with the other day, I really am sorry about that. Yes. I'm sorry, Ash. It was rude and I didn't mean for it to come out that way. A short but tense pause follows. They're both stalling. Under normal circumstances, I'd wait. With these two, the more you force it, the more they'll clamp down on it. Okay, so he apologized to Ash, but I think Ash just isn't saying anything, so skip. And there we go, finally Ash. Yes, it is Ashton who first breaks it.
No, don't apologize.
You were a little bit insensitive.
I should have listened.
How is everything with you
horrible
lately, Zach?
Hold on, Ash, both of you. Did I just hear you say that? Is this why Isabella's here? Has something happened?
Calm down, we're just here to check on things. So, did you meet Andrew
about
the photos?
What photographs?
Wanna see them? They're pretty neat. A set of photographs has been sitting untouched since the day I dumped them in my drawer. There we go. Here you go. Have fun. Isabella goes very still when I hand her the small stack. To her credit, she does not flinch like I'm expecting her to and flips through each of it in silence. Yeah. But while her eyes remain strangely calm, her hands have gone rigid and her mouth has set into a thin line. Yes. She, out of all people, understands what this means. In hindsight, she should have been the one I approached before Ash. Yeah, why didn't you?
What did Andrew say
about
them?
Well, he said not to meddle, of course, but it could be one, but there's no guarantee it's a supernatural thing. It doesn't always happen, so that's a dead end right there. Now that I think about it, bothering that guy for this feels pretty silly now, but with the dreams lately...
That's all? Did he say anything about the damn letter at all?
I didn't actually bring it up, though.
Did you ask him even?
I paused, glancing at him skeptically. I don't know where this sudden curiosity is coming from. But if Ashton, calm, cool, collected, always logical Ashton, takes interest in this, something or someone must have fucked shit up somewhere, yes. Or the world is ending. Alright, seconds pass. The apocalypse I'm expecting to go along with it... The apocalypse I'm expecting to go along with it doesn't arrive, however. Yes. Yeah, that's really everything. The letter kind of slipped my mind. The photos were more important at the time. There was some stuff about the local horror stories, though. Talked about the curses, and he was really fascinated with this story about a wraith asking for a sacrifice to move on. A sacrifice? Like, we gotta kill somebody? We gotta kill Luke? Maybe? Kinda nasty if you ask me, but it does make sense if you simply go along with it. I'm not sure how this will help in the grand scheme of things. Why are you asking about this anyway?
Rose's death isn't just a coincidence.
Yeah, no shit. Okay, should we skip over that? Because she did talk about it. There we go. So we got more news about more people dying that are related to the mansion. And where are we then? What choice did I make here? Ba-la-la-la-la-la. Okay. We can still fix this. Okay, we gotta go say, stay silent. Is there something I can say to make her feel better? Nope. Well, stay silent. I opened my mouth to say something, fishing for little words of encouragement or comfort to lighten the mood. But no sound came out despite my efforts. How can I, when my head is littered with the same thoughts probably plaguing her? It'll be nothing but a half-assed declaration when I've yet to sort myself out. Yet in the end, it is Ash, of all people, who finds them.
We'll find a way. Somehow.
Aww.
I don't know.
Oh, Ash.
This appears to be more complicated than I initially thought, but there has to be some way.
Must be, or else we're all gonna die. The whole thing sounds unexpectedly optimistic for him. He must have realized it as well, because he averts his eyes as soon as the words are out of his mouth, and Isabella turns to him with a look of surprise in her face. Aw, he's blushing! But despite himself, he continues. His tone, careful, hesitant, afraid of saying the wrong thing.
On top of that, we don't have any concrete proof yet. For all we know, it could just be someone clever enough to use those silly legends to cover up for his crimes.
Yeah, but no, it's not the case.
I wouldn't put it past whoever that is. He's gone and killed two people already. But that's why I want to look into this, whether I have this case or not. I want to see for myself what it is. It's my job to know in the first place.
Then, what about...
And even if it is connected in any way, you have me and Zach helping you out. Becca too, I'm sure. She worries most out of anyone. So whatever shit you found yourself in, know you're not alone.
Ash.
Just... promise you won't run off anywhere
by
yourself.
No, that's not gonna happen. Ash rarely ever lies when it matters. Even if finding the right things to say is difficult for him, his words burn with nothing but a simple truth in them. But Isabella doesn't answer. Instead, she looks to me, eyes wide and searching, hoping to find some sort of information to Ash's words in me. Yeah, what he said. I can only offer her a grin and what's perhaps the only thing I'm certain of at this moment. Took the words right out of my mouth. Yes! So I've got to admit, that's the longest I've heard Ash say something.
Shut up, Z-Man.
You ate the whole bag of chips I was saving for the weekend. You're in no position to tell me to shut up.
I was going to replace it.
Okay, can we skip on that? Because we did talk about the chip. We started to get into like lighter talks. Nope, okay, never mind. Alright, game. Everything after quickly dissolves into our usual banter. Yeah. But when a small smile spreads across her lips and the tense lines on her shoulders ease, I know we've given her something far more than empty reassurances. They take their leave mere minutes close to sundown. But regardless of the lighter mood, little has been said of their plans, only vague hints of what they're aiming to do after. While it ain't any of my business to know, something about the whole thing still gnaws at me. A tiny passing thought urges me to do something as well. And what are we doing? This is new? I don't know. It looks not new, but okay, I'm just gonna skip on ahead then, you guys. Okay, and knowing that whoever she is, she had once been human. Yes, so here we are. We are here at the QTE. Can we fail the QTE? Oh no, I might skip out of the QTE. No, this is the QTE, right here. We can fail out on it, but like, I'm gonna skip it just for the sake of progressing with the story, and then of course I'll come back to it. Cause we got a lot of shit, holy shit. Oh my, oh, we got a Marianne? Oh, we can end at Marianne's route right here, holy crap. And then there's more over here, oh my god. Okay, girl, shut up. There we go. Perhaps not all of it is gone. Perhaps some of it is still there. Nope, for now she's demon. Hello? I know you're in here. What do you want? Something moves behind me, a soft scuttling over the walls, followed by the squelch and painful creak of what can only be rotten flesh and broken bones. Okay, I'm gonna skip on ahead, skip on the QTE, and proceed on to the story, you guys. Nope, I can help you. Whatever it is that keeps you here, I can help. Oh, he's trying to communicate. I don't think he did it before. That's what the letter's for, ain't it? You don't have to keep taking people's lives. Hello? There's a brief moment of silence after, for a short while, I think my pleas worked. No. Then, with no warning, the shuffling resumes, and along with it are the sobs of a woman. Okay, can I skip on ahead now? She don't want my help.
You? How the hell did you get
Hello?
In here?
Anyways, we are here. Did we get new journal entries for this? Now, upon returning, blah blah blah, yes. He also warned Zach to be careful. Yes, we already got that from Ash. Okay, anyways. Hello, Mr. Wright, and your dark cloud of doom around you.
What in seven hells do
I
you want?
I just wanted to let you know that you're a very good-looking man.
It's bloody six I in know. The morning!
Listen, sir, I know this is not a good time yet.
Oh, it's not a good time! Did you even check the clock before coming here? I bet you
Okay,
didn't.
I think I'm gonna skip on ahead just because I think that one dialogue line is just because we haven't really met before formally, so he's not really too familiar with us. So yeah, I'm gonna skip on ahead. What did they do to you? I can help you, you know. If I'll let you move on, I'll gladly do so. Yeah, if I'll let you move on, I'll gladly do so. Okay, so he's just trying to be like, you know, ghost hunter shit. Be like, hello, you know, anyone here? You don't have to kill anyone. Nothing. Right. I don't even know who I'm talking to or if a sane person is supposed to be doing that. The only thing I got after is a feeling of foolishness washing over me. Or perhaps this is just me losing my mind. Out of the other options and any other ideas, I let my hands slide off the door's surface and fall listlessly to my sides. I can go back to Luxborn. Try to find the others. Yes, try to get out of this mess with them. Or let them know how much in deep shit we all are. Yes, both sounds good. Yeah. Either way, my loitering here ain't helping at all. Okay. Where are we in story? Looks the same, but let's skip on ahead if it allows us to. Ooh, here we go. Someone could be in danger. It was the crying. We heard the crying in the window. Oh my god. Okay. Holy shit. Okay, so the last time we said to just forget it, keep looking for Ash, but no, this time we're gonna be like, let's enter the window. Oh my god. Okay, let's enter the window. Enter the window. God damn. I can search for Ash, but what if it's too late by then? With how big this place is, he can be anywhere, and it's very likely by the time we come back, someone's already bit the dust. That and the cries grow louder against my ear the longer I linger. Almost impossible to ignore, drawing me in like a moth to a flame. For a moment, I let myself shudder, shaking the uneasy feeling off my head. This can't be a good idea, not by a long shot. I know! Still, I've gotta try. Funnily enough, for a couple as high profile as the Wrights, they don't seem to have any security detail patrolling around. A few guards here and there, sure, but no one will expect they'll have more considering the size of the place. But one will expect more considering the size of the place, right? It works to my advantage though, and I really can't complain when there's a high chance I might get arrested for what I'm about to do. Will I get arrested? Jesus Christ. Luckily, the window's wide enough for me to fit through without making any noise. Hello? There's certainly no going back now. Oh shit, we're inside. We are inside. But as soon as I step into the parlor, all of it ceases while I find no trace of the woman I heard crying like I'm expecting to. The room is still empty at this time of the morning, and I'm left standing awkwardly in the middle of the hush. Maybe she just hid somewhere? No. Hello, are you here? I heard someone earlier, and I'm here to help. God. Hoping for an answer, I let the question hang in the air. But several seconds merely go by without a word or the slightest movement to indicate there is someone in here. has been here. With the stories I've heard, the things I've seen, it takes effort to keep my brain from going into that line of thought. I'm not going to hurt you. If you're here, say something. Nothing. Do you want an EVP? Am I just hearing things? No, I'm pretty sure I hurt someone. But with no one responding, I can't help but feel silly like this. Yeah, better get up while you can. The awareness that I've just trespassed a house for nothing because of some voice prickles at me. Right. Suddenly the silence feels uncomfortable and a kneading anxiety slowly creeps up my back. Okay. I should get out while I can. If it ain't there, it ain't there. I don't spare the room another glance when I walk back the way I came. Out into the window, leave before someone else notices.
I thought I heard a servant moving around here. Turns out it's just a rat scurrying about.
Johannes! My good man, Johannes. I can explain. I can certainly explain.
How unpleasant.
Oh, man. Oh, my heart shoots up into my throat. This is not what it looks like. I can run. The window is a few steps away, but that just makes you look bad. I should be able to escape. But instead, out of some foolish impulse, I turn around. Perhaps it's because the only impression the guy has left in me, what few times we met, is nothing but unsettling. This ain't what you think it is.
You're quite the distance from the kitchen, I'm afraid.
Oh, is that a racist remark?
Perhaps I should lead you there.
Hey now. Someone's in there before me. I wasn't here for what you're thinking. There was sobbing and... Ouch! The first blow knocks the wind out of me, sending me heaving and crumpling to my knees. You're very fast. Tears roll up in my eyes as the pain swells when he twists my wrist behind my back. You've got to listen to me.
Then again, dirty thieves aren't welcome in my kitchen either.
Ow. Ow! For a moment there is only silence and a sudden piercing ache, this time at the back of my head. He just done knocked me out. Dude! There we go. Oh, there's Johan. So, a terrified Zachary went looking for Ashton in the Ermengarde mansion, but to no avail. He also tried to warn Luke Wright about the spirits supposedly living in the house, but was simply turned away. After hearing a crying woman, Zachary sneaked into the mansion, but was unfortunately spotted by the Wright's butler. Yes. Jesus Christ. The room abruptly tilts on its axis, dimming. On the verge of unconsciousness, I can only hear the scuffling of foot, the thud of the door being closed, and... a woman crying, asking for help. Hi, girl. Hey, girl. You locked in here, too? I know no more. Okay. Bye. Darkness claims me. Am I still in Zachary's point of view? I'm pretty sure I am. Yes, all this is yet to be opened. Oh, my gosh. The pain is the worst when I come to, a sharp, piercing ache somewhere at the back of my head begging to be noticed. But it's nothing I can't handle. Blearily, I open my eyes, expecting to be greeted by sunlight. Nope. I'm in the cellar! Nope! What the fuck? However, the walls that welcome me are unfamiliar. Curiosity killed the cat. Oh! I guess he called the police on me, huh? When everything comes into focus, I recognize the place for what it is. A cell. Dark, cramped, with the only light coming from the moon outside, streaming through the sole window, barred by thick metal bars. Memory rushes back to me in sharp bursts, the mansion looking for Ashton, a familiar tune, and a woman crying. All while my head still aches from the hit I've received. Still better than a morgue, I guess? Right. Gingerly, I pull myself up, stretching the cramps from my shoulders as I do so, but stopping when a sudden movement induces an acute stinging pain right through my arm. Damn, they got me good. What time is it? Late. As expected, they've taken everything I have on my person, wallet, cell phone, my keys, meds, even a small pack of gum. Protocol is protocol. In the first place, ending back in another cell ain't in my agenda. Right. The first time was not a pleasant experience, and this certainly won't be either. Considering who has likely put me in here, it could be much worse. The bars are cold to my touch when I approach it, looking for the person on duty. They'd usually allow us to contact someone, and Ashton, at least, has to know I'm here. He'll be pissed, that I'm quite sure of, but he's the only one who can help prove my innocence and get me out. However much I don't want to rely on him for this, because it looks bad. The hallway in front of the cell is empty, but voices float through from further in, likely the poor officers assigned to late-night duty. Judging from the snippets of conversation I catch, today's topic over a snack is that moron who thought it's wise to cross rights. It's me. They use other names too, most of which I'll like to have words with them about in the future. Oh, right. But really, I'm in no position right now. Excuse me, anyone? Silence. Excuse me, I need to make a... Oh no, she's in here with me too! Are you kidding me? Blood freezes in my veins and my grip on the bar tightens as the revolting scent reaches my nose. More than the gore, the foul smell of death hangs heavily in the air. And against my better judgment, I turn. It's my cellmate! Hello! Hello, lady! Her face is the first thing I see. I'm gonna read this journal entry first. When Zachary finally regains consciousness after being knocked out, he found himself locked up in a precinct. A familiar woman gave him a little visit. Yes. Hi, girl! Hey, girl! A gruesome sight on its own, eyes gleaming with nothing but malevolence. I can't read. Blood oozing from the large punctured wound on her head, mouth open wide in a voiceless scream. I clamp on the compulsion to retch. On instinct, I step back, putting as much distance as this cramped cell will allow between us. Oop! The bars rattle as soon as my shoulders hit it. A hindrance not to freedom, but to safety. You gotta stop this. We can't help you this way, right? She moves in short, sudden, bone-crunching twitches. Hey now, girl. And I know there is no escape. I'm screaming for help before I know it, jolting the bars with as much force as I could. Somebody, get me out of here. Anyone, please.
Bugger off! Some people are trying to get some sleep.
Oh, fuck off. No, she's here. You gotta let me out. She's gonna kill me. Someone, she's... Now she's smiling. Oh no. Oh. Oh, you poor dear. Oh no. Oh no? Is that the end for Zachary? Really? Oh. Wait. You've unlocked a memory. What the fuck? Well, that's fucked up. It's fucking her, Elizabeth. Oh my god. Oh my gosh, she really was a bitch. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. Maybe she's done that after she caught, after Takako caught her cheating on her fiance, and that's like her way of keeping her quiet, I'm pretty sure. Anyways, but that's still fucked up. Oh my god. Anyways, whoa. Then how the hell? Oh, wow. Rebecca. What? Wait, hold on, no. I'm in fucking Marianne. Okay, anyways. There we go. Oh, wow, we died! Ending 2, Variant A. Whoa! Okay. Oh, sorry. Anyways. Whoa! What the shit? Let's see. Where to then? Because I can definitely go... The only place I can go back on is going back to where we were talking to Hana. And a couple of other choices that we got along the way here. Like the newer ones. Maybe I'll do the newer ones just to stay within the path instead of diverging back up to where I would show the pictures to Hana and then going from there. I'm gonna see where I am for time, just in case. But yeah, do that much, and then we'll proceed to do Hana's branching point in the next episode then. And then, of course, try to get, I guess, the other possibilities. So yeah, where am I? What am I? Where am I? Who am I? What am I? Oh god. What was the newer choices that we had? Not here, not here. Here? Maybe? I think it was one of them. Okay, let's see. This one, you're the one who started it. This is when we were talking about this, his sister. So, just say you're the one who started it. You do realize you're the one who started it.
Yeah, well, your sister tried to poison me
yes,
with her cooking.
Yes, of course. Does that give me points? No, obviously not. So, like, you can cook better.
My cooking has never killed people.
Your brand of cooking mostly involves storing things into a pot and hope it never explodes.
I'm never going to live that one down,
no,
am
not.
I?
No, you're not. It was in the news. Oh my god, did you know Nana and Gran called me that night just to check if you're still alive? And they were genuinely concerned. They've always been. It's in some unspoken agreement, my grandparents has adopted him into the family. Oh, that's cute. A nice gesture, and I don't think he minds it at all. He'd even ask about them from time to time, check on their well-being. I think a part of him misses his own family, the one he'll never get back, and though he won't say it out loud, he appreciates having one thing close to it. Yeah, makes him feel less lonely. Who won't? Yeah. And yet, you should drop by sometimes, Nana's request. She wants to see whether that skinny boy has somehow gained some muscle.
I'll see what I can do.
Alright, sometimes he neglects the more important things. Ash.
Some other time, Zach. Things are a bit hectic at the moment.
Even for just a day? Come on, Ash.
You saw how things are at the precinct. Even Benjamin's at his wit's end.
I know, but he is quick to avoid my eyes, swiftly turning his attention back on his plate. The food, however, remains uneaten. He's put up a wall again. I can't remember the last time he did that, but watching it happen in front of me is disconcerting. It's an excuse, I know that. His job is never as easy as those television shows often imply, lots of bureaucracy and red tape involved. If he's lucky, they'll find an easy lead, close the case after several months of no sleep and pure hard work. But most of the time, it's just one pile of reports after the next, one frustration after another. I just wish he'd stop focusing on it too much and see what he's missing out on for once. You really can't make time for it?
I can't just leave this case for now.
Okay.
Sorry.
Alright, his change in tone is subtle, but his aggravation over the matter hangs completely palpable in the air. Okay, so we're gonna skip on ahead to the other choice that I screwed up on. So yeah, here we go. So it's really just a gig. Let's just reassure him then. There. Patience can be a tough thing to summon at times, but we didn't get this far as friends if we let our own tempers be the lord of us. Bro, it's really just another freelance work. Yeah, he eyes me skeptically, the same stare he reserves for people he interrogates. I've been on the receiving end of it before, early in our friendship. Years later, he's already got the unimpressed police look down pat. And there's nothing going on with me and Miss Hana. She was just being friendly, insisted I call her by her first name, that's all.
I wasn't implying any of that. You're not that sort of guy.
I know, but let's just get that out of the way. The just-in-case elephant-in-the-room scenario, right? Okay, yeah. She's a married woman, Jesus.
Not with the image she presents in public.
On. Yeah. Nope, but trust me, she ain't any of the things the tabloid writes about her.
Like I read any
sure
of those.
Sure you do. I know you don't. But keep it in mind, will you?
Okay. Will do. Though I can't promise you'll get off scot-free if she's involved. Man, with how you're acting, it feels like I'm doing a solid for your girlfriend.
What? Cut that out, will you? And I'm not asking you to. Besides, what's currently going on here is more important.
Alright.
Okay, there we go. So he's taking it rather graciously. Recounting everything takes the better half of our lunch, but he manages to listen through the entire thing without a snide comment. A feat in itself, actually. At the end of it, Ash merely nods, takes out his phone, and excuses himself. Okay. Off to a far corner of the cafe for some privacy, if you can even afford to have such in a place as public as this. Right, nothing is private in a cafe. Alright, and he returns in a little while and hands me a small card. Oh, okay, see, so I did say that, like, he would hand us the card, the business card, either way, to, like, have us see Professor Clark, but he's doing it much more in, like, a civilized way. It's like, everything's cool.
I can't stop you if you're willing to believe in this crap. Give this guy a call. You're better off talking to him than me.
Yes, okay.
He's at the public library now if you want to catch him there. He used to be my professor back in the university.
Right. Oh no, I don't think that's...
Go on, I already gave him a heads up.
Okay.
You know I can't help you out, man.
Alright. He gives my arm a tap and walks off, mumbling about checking back how things are at the precinct. I don't see his face when he leaves, but I know this is his own little way of helping out despite what he doesn't voice out. So he's like, indirectly wants to help us out. Before it wasn't so friendly, it didn't come off as so friendly, but this time, of course, he's like, he's like doing it in a more friendly way. Okay. Yes, disturbed Zachary decides to show that blah blah blah, refusing to believe his friend, Ash invites him to talk to Andrew instead. Yes, okay. I think that's all I'm going to do, yes, because... Basically, from here on out, there's no other choices left. Where the hell am I? Oh, wait. Damn it, there's some here. Wait, hold on, what's this? Oh, this is a story update. Never mind. No, never mind. I just want choices. Choices? Choices? Nope, story update. Blah, 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 blah. What's this? Story update. Okay. So all this is just story updates, I believe. Down here, we didn't even get it because, again, I'm not too sure what I need to do. So yes, this is all I'm gonna do, you guys, for this episode. We are going to continue on to try to do the other branches in the next one. So yes, which is basically just going up here to tell Hana instead of to tell Ash, and then we're gonna go around here, branch around here, get all this stuff, get all this and this and this, and go back to ending off where we can end up with Marianne's point of view to right over down here instead of over here. So yes, and then of course we have so much other shit to unlock here, and I'm pretty sure it just has something to do with what's it called, whether or not we continue in Isabella's and how she ended up dying, or blah, 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 or even Hana when she ended up dying because Luke killed her, blah, 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 and et cetera, and all these other factors that we saw previously in Isabella or Hana's route. So, yeah, oh my god, we can actually finally see the consequences of those events and how it will affect Zachary's route here. So, yeah, anyways, guys, I'm gonna leave you here. So, until then, I will see you guys in another Let's Play. The story is thickening. Oh my god, we got another, like, as you can see, another scene. Another little memory piece that we saw, and I think the story's kind of piecing together. I think we got the majority of what happened and what caused the curse, and yeah, I can't wait to see like the full extent of it. But as of now, like, damn, no wonder she mad. what's it called? Elizabeth? I swear her name's Elizabeth. Like, she's a total bitch. What the hell? She's a complete bitch to her. Man. And after, because she caught her, like, cheating or having an affair with some next rando guy, like her servant or whatever the hell. Anyways, until then, you guys, I will see you then. But for now, bye! Scary skeletons and shivers down your spine. Shrieking skulls will shock your